Here are live images from the BJP headquarters at 11 Ashok Road. The parliamentary party meeting is over. You see Prime Minister Narendra Modi in the middle, flanked to his left by Home Minister Rajnath Singh. To his immediate right, the new BJP president, the new Shahenshah of the BJP, the miracle man from Uttar Pradesh, the man though with a very checkered and a very controversial past, Amit Shah. And now we'll hear the decision being made official. As we wait for order to be restored, we'll soon see Rajnath Singh in his truly professorial way asking the journalists to calm down for allowing for proceedings to begin.
Mitro, aap sabhi ka swagat hai. Mitro, please. Aap sabhi ka swagat hai. Aap sabko jankari hai. 23 January 2013 ko मैंने भारतीय जनता पार्टी के राष्ट्रीय अध्यक्ष के रूप में जिम्मेदारी संभाली थी और मैं जानता हूं कि जब मैंने 23 जनवरी 2013 को अध्यक्ष के दायित्व को संभाला था उस समय मैंने सहज मन से इसे स्वीकार नहीं किया था बहुत ही भारी मन से और असहज मन से उस दायित्व को मैंने स्वीकार किया था क्योंकि हम सभी के एक मित्र उस समय के अध्यक्ष नितिन जी गडकरी जी के ऊपर जिस प्रकार के बेबुनियाद और निराधार आरोप चस्पा किए गए थे उस कारण मैं असहज अपने को महसूस कर रहा था और उनके त्यागपत्र देने के परिणाम स्वरूप मैंने इस जिम्मेदारी को संभाला और डेढ़ वर्षों का जो समय गुजरा है इस डेढ़ वर्षों के समय में सभी का सहयोग श्रद्धेय आडवाणी जी का आशीर्वाद जिसके परिणाम स्वरूप हम सबको इन डेढ़ वर्षों के अंदर एक ऐसी शानदार कामयाबी हासिल हुई है जिसे आप सभी अच्छी तरह परिचित हैं मैं आज के समय यह भी उल्लेख करना चाहूंगा कि भारतीय जनता पार्टी को सचमुच पहले यहां पर एक ऊंचाई देने का काम यदि किसी ने किया तो हमारे श्रद्धेय अटल जी श्रद्धेय आडवाणी जी ने भारतीय जनता पार्टी को भारत की राजनीति में एक ऊंचाई दी है और यदि मैं यह कहूं कि भारत की राजनीति को यूनिपोलर पार्टी को बाईपोलर पार्टी बनाने का काम यदि किसी के नेतृत्व में हुआ है तो हमारे श्रद्धेय अटल जी और श्रद्धेय आडवाणी जी के नेतृत्व में हुआ है लेकिन उसके बाद 2013 के बाद जब हम लोगों ने जिम्मेदारी श्री नरेंद्र भाई मोदी जो आज हमारे भारत के प्रधानमंत्री हैं उनके नेतृत्व में हम लोगों ने चुनाव लड़ा तो आप सबको जानकारी है कि भारतीय जनता पार्टी सबसे बड़ी पॉलिटिकल पार्टी के रूप में इमर्ज होकर इस देश में आई है और यह भी सच्चाई है कि भारतीय जनता पार्टी पहली ऐसी नॉन कांग्रेस पॉलिटिकल पार्टी है जिसने भारत की संसद में क्लियर मेजॉरिटी हासिल की है और इसका श्रेय यहां पर मैं श्री नरेंद्र भाई मोदी जो आज हमारे भारत के प्रधानमंत्री हैं उनको देना चाहता हूं वहीं पर अपने सारे जितने भी भारतीय जनता पार्टी के हमारे वरिष्ठ सहयोगी हैं उनको देना चाहता हूं श्रद्धेय आडवाणी जी श्रद्धेय अटल जी इन लोगों का जो आशीर्वाद रहा है इन सबके परिणाम स्वरूप कार्यकर्ताओं के अथक परिश्रम के परिणाम स्वरूप यह कामयाबी हासिल हुई है चूंकि प्रधानमंत्री जी ने मुझे अपने मंत्रिमंडल में गृह मंत्री के रूप में जिम्मेदारी दी यह स्वाभाविक था जैसी भारतीय जनता पार्टी की परंपरा है मैंने फैसला किया कि अब इस अध्यक्ष के दायित्व को हमें छोड़ना चाहिए तो आज भारतीय जनता पार्टी सेंट्रल पार्लियामेंट्री बोर्ड की मैंने बैठक बुलाई और मैंने अपना त्यागपत्र दिया पार्लियामेंट्री बोर्ड ने मेरे त्यागपत्र को स्वीकार किया है और सर्वसम्मत से श्री अमित शाह जी को भारतीय जनता पार्टी के राष्ट्रीय अध्यक्ष के रूप में अपनी सहमति दी है आज से और अभी से श्री अमित शाह अब भारतीय जनता पार्टी के राष्ट्रीय अध्यक्ष के रूप में अपनी जिम्मेदारी का निर्वाह करेंगे अमित शाह का परिचय देने की आवश्यकता नहीं है मैं यह कह सकता हूं कि काल्पनिक क्षमता के धनी हैं अमित शाह जी और साथ ही साथ ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल स्किल, संगठनात्मक कुशलता जो चाहिए संगठन को चलाने की, वह भी उनके अंदर है। और साथ ही साथ प्रबंधन के मामले में यानी मैनेजमेंट स्किल भी, जो हम कहते हैं कभी कभी किसी कामयाबी को हासिल करने के लिए जिसकी आवश्यकता होती है, वह मैनेजमेंट स्किल भी उनके अंदर है। और उत्तर प्रदेश में प्रभारी रहते हुए जिस प्रकार की शानदार सफलता उन्होंने उत्तर प्रदेश में दिलाई है, मैं कह सकता हूं कि भारतीय जनता पार्टी के इतिहास में उत्तर प्रदेश में वैसी शानदार सफलता कभी नहीं हासिल हुई है। इसीलिए हम सभी ने सोच विचार कर यह फैसला किया कि अब राष्ट्रीय अध्यक्ष की जिम्मेदारी श्री अमित शाह जी को सौंपनी चाहिए, और हम लोगों ने आज उन्हें राष्ट्रीय अध्यक्ष के रूप में मनोनीत किया है। मैं अपनी तरफ से और अपने सभी वरिष्ठ सहयोगियों की तरफ से उनको हार्दिक बधाई देता हूं, उनको हार्दिक शुभकामनाएं देता हूं। और मुझे पूरा विश्वास है कि आज भारतीय जनता पार्टी का जो स्ट्रेचर है उससे भी अधिक भारतीय जनता पार्टी का भारत की राजनीति में स्ट्रेचर बनाने में श्री अमित शाह जी के नेतृत्व में हम सबको कामयाबी हासिल होगी। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद। आइए अमित जी,
यहाँ
Amit Shah being made the BJP's new president, a huge moment. He once told me that he has really terrible luck, that this one Guruji of his who was a tribal in Rajasthan told him this story, that you're like the man on the camel. No matter what your station in life, no matter how high you rise from the ground, a dog will always come and bite you, even if you're sitting on the camel. This story he told, and Dr. Lahiri was there. He's here now with us. This is when we were traveling on the Election Express, and he was very unhappy with the fact that he got into trouble with the Election Commission. And he said that, you know, no matter what I do, no matter what I say, I always seem to get into trouble, even if I try my best to stay away from it. But this, of course, is a huge moment. Dr. Lahiri, I want your sense on whether he'll be able to replicate the performance of Uttar Pradesh in the forthcoming elections in Maharashtra and Haryana. Do you think he can do it?
See, time is limited. I have immense admiration for Mr. Amit Shah's magic in electoral politics, what he did in UP. I think even BJP did not expect such a...
Neither did he.
Such a fantastic performance. But I would say that the non-BJP parties should be worried that here is a general who is coming. I mean, if you think of the Second World War, you think of Field Marshal Rommel in the desert. And the Montgomery was worried. So similarly, when Amit Shah has come as the general for the BJP in Haryana and Maharashtra, I think the non-BJP parties will be worried, should be worried.
That's interesting. You're saying that they should be worried, but it can also be counter-argued that he was lucky that there was as much anger against the SP, that there was a consolidation taking place in favor of Modi, in favor of the BJP, and that helped push the BJP over the hump. Now, to create similar conditions in Maharashtra and Haryana will be a tougher task. But do you think it is his strategy that enabled that to happen?
See, anti-incumbency is common. See, both in UP, both in Haryana and Maharashtra, you have a non-BJP government. Congress is ruling. UP also had a non-BJP government. So the anti-incumbency will go in favor of BJP. And now how that anti-incumbency factor is combined with Amit Shah's magic is the question.
But look, he didn't say anything. He's been completely below the radar, Uday Mahurkar, after the 16th of May, allowing for things to play out in a way. He knew that Modi wanted him to be president. There was a time when JP Nadda's name was being spoken of. That's OP Mathur, the General Secretary of the BJP, now in conversation with Prime Minister Modi. Harshvardhan right behind him. Both OP Mathur and JP Nadda were candidates. They would have been lightweight, featherweight candidates. Amit Shah is the real draw.
But Rahul, what it reminds me are two things. One, like in the case of marriage, in the United States, people say two consenting adults are getting married. What do we have to say about it? Mm-hmm. It's their matter. So Congress is also saying it's a BJP's internal matter. BJP also says Congress's internal matter. But BJP talks about dynasty. And Congress comes out and says Amit Shah has got this allegation against him and so on. But what it reminds me, I'm coming to the second thing, that during Panditji's time, the Prime Minister was the main person of the party. Now we are going back to those days. A few months ago we are talking about dual centers of power, accidental prime minister, and whether someone remote control. Now it seems the allegations are Mr. Modi and Mr. Amit Shah too close to each other. But since we have seen a weak prime minister, let's see how a strong prime minister performs. It will be a completely different model.
You know, just as an outside observer, occasionally looking at electoral stuff, you know, you already have the evidence on Maharashtra of the central election, and this state elections are within a year. So that vote is out there. I think what his role will be to translate that into assembly
seats. But there's a big challenge there.
Yeah.
The BJP has far fewer seats in the assembly elections than the Shiv Sena. They want a much bigger pie of shares. The Shiv Sena doesn't want to relent.
I saw his contribution in UP was that he translated the groundswell for Modi into actual winnable seats.
Sure. If he can pull it off,
that is his key.
In the BJP pantheon, he'll become another or maybe even bigger than Pramod Mahajan, as the man with the magic wand, the man who could make.
Yeah, but it's the translation which he does. The vote is for Modi in a way.
You're watching our live coverage on the elevation of Amit Shah as the new BJP president. We're getting images from Mumbai, from the BJP headquarters, where there are celebrations taking place. Remember, Maharashtra is where the next big electoral battle takes place. Huge challenges there, with the Shiv Sena asserting itself, with Uddhav Thackeray making it clear he wants to be next chief minister of Maharashtra, with Gopinath Munde no longer in the fray. Amit Shah faces a very tough challenge. Nitin Gadkari says he doesn't want to go back to the state. Devinder Fadnavis is too young to be projected as the BJP's chief ministerial candidate. What can Amit Shah do? Can he replicate that magic? Now, I want to go across to Uday Mahurkar on what strategy Amit Shah has already worked out. Because, you know, from what he told us, at the time of the elevation of Modi as the BJP's prime ministerial candidate was, that my strategy is that I already have a game plan at work. I'm just waiting for the announcement to be made and then you see how we roll it out. And that's exactly what he did, where Modi undertook a massive blitzkrieg all across the country. Does he have a similar strategy already in place for Maharashtra, Haryana? Uday, do we know what that strategy is?
Not so much, but what I can guess is that there's a huge groundswell of support for Modi and Amit Shah, for Modi amongst the people of voters of Maharashtra, and for Amit Shah within the party. But having said that, I must say that if anybody is expecting that Amit Shah will go, he will try to ruffle the feathers of the Shiv Sena, I don't think he will cross a certain point in that. This is what I believe.
Okay, let me give a counter take to that, because Uddhav Thackeray believes he's the right candidate to be the new Maharashtra chief minister. They've got many more seats in the assembly elections than the BJP has, as per the seat allocation ratio. The BJP now believes it is the bigger, the more prominent party. They believe that the votes are being won on Modi's name and they want a bigger share of that pie. And in that sense, there is a certain synergy between Amit Shah and Nitin Gadkari, both of whom feel the BJP must assert itself. And the Raj Thackeray card is something that Nitin Gadkari has used in the past. Amit Shah believes that that can be leverage that the BJP can exercise against the Shiv Sena to try and ensure that they get a more substantial chunk of the seats. And that, Dr. Lahiri, is only fair. Given the relative strengths of the two parties in Maharashtra, the BJP will want Amit Shah to establish the BJP as the bigger brother in Maharashtra, as the elder brother in Maharashtra, and not play second fiddle to the Shiv Sena?
I'll be surprised if BJP fails to get a higher number of seats to contest. Because as you rightly pointed out, Raj Thackeray's MNS is very much there. So as long as Mansa is there, he can play Mansa against Shiv Sena. And the power struggle within the Shiv Sena is still not over, though Uddhav Thackeray ji has established his control. It's not secure. Furthermore, Rahul, you must remember also the NCP is there, Nationalist Congress Party. There may be lots of statements about how they will be loyal to the Congress and so on. But I'm sure there are some chinks in the armor of that coalition as well.
Okay, Dr. Lahiri suggests that the opposition must be worried. I want to put that question to Shobha Oza, because BJP workers are dancing in Mumbai and they're hoping that Amit Shah will help them dance all the way to victory. Now, is the Congress concerned, given his track record in Uttar Pradesh, where he engineered an electoral miracle bigger than you would have ever imagined? Are you concerned about the fact that you drew a comparison with General Rommel, that you've got a field marshal who's now far more potent than anything in the Congress arsenal?
Rahul, Congress is not worried at all, because we have governments in Maharashtra and Haryana which have been doing very well. And as far as Mr. Amit Shah's track record is, let me remind you, who he always tries to criminalize, polarize the entire elections. And the claims they had made before the election as far as inflation was concerned, now the people of this country are disillusioned with the government already. So now we need not worry, they're exposed, and whether it is Mr. Amit Shah or any other person for that matter heads the BJP, it is of it will not make a difference to the Congress. The Congress will come back in both the states with thumping majority for the work, good work they have done in the two states. And the people of the two states are disillusioned, as the people of the other part of the country, with the present government. The tall claims they made before the elections totally stand exposed. And as far as Mr. Amit Shah is concerned, I congratulate BJP for bringing the real mask or bringing the real face. And that's what the ideology of BJP and RSS stands for. Mr. Amit Shah is the real face of these organizations, though they have been trying to fool this country for long, saying that they are a party with a difference and that Chandra and Chera they care for. So this is the real picture or the real ideology, with Amit Shah personifies their ideology and their character.
Okay, I want to put this question to Professor Bandukwala. Do you, sir, as an also an observer of Gujarat politics, think Amit Shah can do for the BJP in Haryana, Delhi and Maharashtra what he was able to do in Uttar Pradesh? Do you think it was the Modi moment that sprung the BJP to power in Uttar Pradesh? Or do you think Amit Shah played a huge role in engineering that victory and making it possible for Modi?
See, Amit Shah's politics revolves around polarizing. The entire politics is to unite all Hindu castes against Muslims. A dangerous game. See, we saw it only recently in UP, in Muzaffarnagar, and even in Moradabad. Earlier, Amit Shah played the role in these various encounter cases. Now this time, Amit Shah evokes a lot of fear amongst Muslims. See, Muslims constitute 20 crores in India. This population is very huge. And it is not wise to have such a huge population living in fear of one man. I think it could lead to very dangerous consequences. I wish people would realize, particularly Modi wants to rule over an India that is one, that is united, then he has to control Amit Shah. See, as far as Muslims are concerned,
okay,
Amit Shah is always identified with Ishrat Jahan. And Ishrat case evokes a lot of empathy amongst Muslims.
Well, that's one perspective. From Amit Shah's perspective, of course, the challenge is to deliver victories for the BJP in the forthcoming assembly elections and strengthen the BJP, as he says, in West Bengal and Tamil Nadu, which he believes are key states where the BJP can do much better than it does at this time. We're slipping into a quick break. When we come back, we'll focus on the economic survey. We'll look at the key details and we'll get our economists to tell us what this could mean for the general budget tomorrow. And we'll return, of course, to the celebrations, the wild celebrations all across, where BJP workers are out on the streets. They're celebrating the elevation and the appointment of their new president. And look at those faces. Those are faces that believe that Amit Shah can lead them to victory. That's why they're so happy. They're hoping he can do for them what he did in UP. Our coverage resumes on the other side of a quick break.